Nearly half of Americans say that they avoid reading the news. It's a problem both for citizens and in journalists. These are startling kinds of numbers that I read. This was in The Guardian. And well, first of all, give me your take on that story where they say 42% of the public now avoids the news totally. And I want to go through the list of reasons.
Yeah, I think it's obviously a very bad thing for this country. We're already so misinformed and uninformed as it is. So for almost half the country to say, you know what, I'm just done with the news, it is really bad for our public education. But then again, if you are a regular news consumer, you're still probably not getting real, actual, factual news. So I don't know if it's bad that people aren't watching the news or if it's good that people aren't watching the news. I just know we've got some big problems, and I don't even know where to begin.
Here's the list of things that the writers say that the reason that the news is in the hole right now. Loss of confidence in the news. Hate agendas. They say there's too much hate agenda by the news. That's untrustworthy. These are words that come out of these polls, that the bias is such that they can't believe what they're being told, that it's inaccurate most of the time. It's going to be inaccurate when they do their own look and they find out, well, was this true? It's self-serving. Now, you and I have talked about this, self-serving and the fact that they're going to let an advertiser get away with a hell of a lot. For example, the pharmaceutical industry, advertising on all the media, every 4 seconds you have an ad. Well, it's very difficult to break through and have the news actually report that that pharmaceutical that they're advertising is killing people. Or how about the weapons industry that you like to talk about?
Yeah, they're sitting there, Boeing, you know, advertising, oh, look at our wonderful jet engines. GE is another one. Look at, we're making these wonderful jet engines here on this commercial. What are you even selling?
Yeah. I mean, we're not. Are you going to buy a jet engine?
I have no plans for it in the future.
But what are they really doing?
They're buying their influence. They're right. Making sure that, hey, you can't go after us because we just spent $40 million this quarter making sure that we're running ads on your network. Yeah. So you got to be nice to us.
That's one of the things that people are recognizing right now.
And it's about time.
Self-serving advertising agendas. The fact, this is startling to me, that they felt like the media is trying to engage in social engineering that are offended, that's offensive to them. Their point being, just give me the news. Another point was that it's being driven, that all the media is being driven by the top 1% elite. But I don't think you can put it all on the media, do you?
No, I think a lot of it has to do with, you know, people just in general seeking out information that just reaffirms what they already believe, you know, the stuff they want to hear. And we do see that all the time. You know, we see it on the left, we see it on the right. People only want to know what they think they already know. Or something, of course, as you pointed out, the hate agenda, that's going to make them angry. Or that's going to show that, hey, this person you dislike did another bad thing. I mean, that's what most of all online media is today.
Yeah, well, they're micro-focused on their agenda. It's almost childlike. You and I joke all the time. We can put up a story that the headlines can be cancer, is cured. Cancer is cured last Wednesday. And we can put that story up, and then right underneath the story with our, I guess with our group of folks that follow it, we can put Trump hatred. We can put Republican hatred. We can put anything that falls on Trump hatred. That story will get more or as many as cured cancer. Now, why is that?
Well, again, people seek out the information that they think is going to make them feel better, you know, that reaffirms whatever it is they already believe. And again, you know, it's not just us. It's everybody with any kind of, you know, political YouTube channel. We see it all the time on the left, on the right. The right is saying, oh, the left is terrible. Watch this horrible thing. Oh, the right is terrible. Watch this horrible thing. And in between that, you know, we always try to give real news, real factual things. We're not afraid to go after both sides when they deserve
but
it.
But watch what happens when we do that. You see, if I stand up here and you talk about the middle, here's the middle position. The outrage is ridiculous. You know, Farron, why are you doing the show with Pap? Pap, you know, you're turning to right. It's the problem is it's almost a childlike analysis. I only want to eat the ice cream. I don't want to eat the vegetables. And so the news is no longer the vegetables. The news is all ice cream. Here, you're a right winger, here's your news. You're a left wing progressive, we know this is all you want to listen to because apparently it's too painful to listen to anything else, so here it is. It's a dangerous place that we are right now.
It really is. And you know, one of the things too that came out of this report was the young people. The young people, and I found this really interesting because it kind of goes back to the olden days, the young people say, we want long form information from podcasts.
Mm-hmm. That is interesting.
But what that reminds me of is, you know, way back in, you know, my young days in the 80s, it was 60 Minutes. That's your long form news. Mm-hmm. Go all the way back, you know, to your Ed Murrows and your Cronkites. That's what it was.
They couldn't exist.
Right, but it almost seems like this young generation wants to go back to that a little bit. They actually say, well, let me hear people explain things.
We think that it's the millennials that are doing this polarized kind of listening. It's not as much as the baby boomers, big surprise. It's the baby boomers that, I swear, you know, people miss the fact, for example, that our law firm owns all of Ring of Fire. And your stories, our stories run progressive about 10 to 1. But even that one story, oh God, don't tell me something I don't want to hear. I think it's dangerous.
It really is. People have to understand, you know, you have to get all sides of it. Otherwise, you're getting propaganda.
Yeah, exactly.
You know, it's not our job to be a cheerleader for one side or the other. And most of the media has gone to the cheerleading role.
Yeah.
You know, it's either our side is better, your side sucks, or everything is okay, everything is fine, these corporations, no, they're not doing anything bad to you.
Even when you do your stories that are beat the hell out of Trump, or beat the hell of the Republicans. Again, that's a Ring of Fire product that we engage in. I mean, we own this. So we want 10 to 1, but we want that middle story to at least get somebody's attention and say, my God, I've never thought about that. Very tough to do nowadays.